like it's all about confidence. And when they will win one game and they get the confidence back, I feel like they will just like keep winning, you know.
So today is the last day of week 2 of the LEC summer season, and I am in the presence of Isma after the match of the week against Fnatic. Unfortunately, ended in a loss for you guys, but still pretty good start to the LEC, 4-1 so far. Isma, how are you feeling so far in the summer split?
I'm sad that we lose today, but overall I'm feeling very good. Like my teammates are playing very, very well, so fine.
And I mean, it must be very good for you guys because, I mean, obviously you had a very strong start to the year in winter. You were like third place in the group stage, but then it faltered a bit. I think you ended in fifth. And then in the spring split, it was a bit of a disaster. You guys were in seventh place, but now you are, I mean, you were tied until today for first place and you are still towards the upper standing pretty much of the league. How do you feel about the improvement of the team this year? And like, are you excited for the prospects of like the rest of the split? Do you think that you guys have what it takes to contend even for like a world spot?
I'm obviously very happy about my team, about my new bot lane as well. I think everyone is playing really well. And yeah, I think we can, I mean, I feel like I'm the one playing bad right now. Like, for example, today, I think it was mostly me. And overall, I feel like I make the game harder for my team. So it's on me to play better. And I think if I do this, we can go to world.
And what do you think is maybe like the biggest issue, I guess, like for you right now? Is it just like a mechanical issue, or maybe you had a bit of miscommunication with teammates as well?
No, I don't think it's a mechanical issue. I think it's I'm very aggressive. And I think it is a problem, like way too much, I feel like. I think that's the problem.
And I mean, it's very interesting because, I mean, as you say, you are like a very aggressive player, but also there's a big contrast because we see you play a lot of Maokai, Sejuani, and like one Poppy game as well. Could you tell me about like those picks as well? Because you seem to be a bit sacrificing yourself for your team maybe and focusing a lot on team play. Is there other picks we haven't seen? Obviously, you don't have to leak anything, but yeah.
No, I mean, I think they are really strong champ right now, and it's very easy to play around them. I mean, I think that's the main thing why I play them, because I think it's the best route. I have other picks that are kind of funny, I would say.
All right, well, I mean, hopefully we get to see them in the playoffs then. But yeah, that aside, I mean, you mentioned obviously your bot lane, Ryle and Luan, that have came in a team this split, and I mean, they are coming in gunslinging, right? Like, everyone is looking at them and saying that they are maybe even like the best bot lane in the LEC. Obviously, only time will tell. We're still very early on, so it's hard to call right now. But how has it been working with them as well? Do they speak English, by the way? And like, how do you communicate with all of them?
Yeah, they both speak English fine. Like, it's not an insane English, but it's enough for me to understand and for my teammate to understand. And I mean, obviously, it's going very well. I have a chin now, so hopefully it keeps and that's it.
And in terms of like personality and stuff, do you think they are like meshing well with the team? Like, are they like making jokes and stuff?
Yeah, it's matching very well, to be honest.
Yeah. Do you have any fun anecdotes as well from your teammates, things that happened since they have arrived?
Not really, no. Not really, no. To be honest, it's kind of classic, you know. But they are, I mean, Lyon especially, have like kind of the same personality as me, so it's very fun. And Red is way more calm. That's it.
But that aside, I mean, obviously this is still your rookie year in the LEC, and now you've had two splits down, and this is your third split right now. I would like to ask as well, with the experience that you've had so far in the LEC, do you still see yourself as a rookie as well, or do you think you're able now to take more of like a leading figure for the team as well, and do you feel like you're more experienced than you were at the start of the year?
I think I would say I'm still kind of a rookie. I mean, sometimes I take the lead, but I would say I'm still kind of a rookie, you know? Like, I still have a lot of pressure on the game, and that's it.
And, I mean, obviously, you have Neski in your team, which is a very experienced player as well. How has it been, like, working with him? Do you, like, see him a bit as, like, a kind of mentor in the team? Do you think he has helped you a lot as well?
Yeah, I mean, he has helped me a lot. I think I would say, yeah. Till now, yeah.
That aside, I mean, obviously, I saw that you were spamming the Mad Lions emote all game as well. Is there a story behind that, or is it just like paying tribute to your ex-teammates, I guess, for Movistar Riders?
Yeah, it's more like shout out to them because I still really like them till now. They are not doing too great for the moment, but I think they will bounce back.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting, right? Because in the last few splits, like maybe they were the one doing a bit better and you were doing a bit worse in terms of like your team performance. And now it's reversed and you are towards the top and they are towards the bottom as well. Speaking of Madeline's core quickly as well, like, what do you think is actually like not going very well for them right now?
I think it's only about confidence. It was like this last year as well. So I think it's only about confidence. I mean, I saw a bit the game against Giant and against KC as well. Like one fight went bad and I feel like people were a bit scared to do stuff. And I feel like in two Giant Techs it's the same. They didn't really play. So I feel like it's all about confidence. And when they will win one game and they get the confidence back, I feel like they will just like keep winning, you know?
And going back to your own team performance as well, I mean, you've had some pretty decent matches still like to play. I mean, I think you've played G2, right? And I mean, now sadly you lost to Fnatic, but still it's been a very good start to the split for you guys. What do you think SK like stands right now, like in terms of the other team? Do you see yourself like as a top three team in the league, for example?
Yeah, I mean, for now, till now, I would say top three. Like, let's see on the next week, you know, if we can get better, let's see.
And speaking of next week, you are going to be facing Team Heretics and Madeline's Core, your old teammates as well there. Which of the two do you like think is going to be maybe like the hardest matchup for you? Is there some stuff you're thinking ahead of these matches already?
I'm not really. I think the hardest one will be Madeline's Core. Because even though they had bad days, I think it's still a good team. So I think Madeline's Core will be the hardest team to beat. And I mean, no, it's always fun to play versus them on stage, right? And Heretics is like really normal, really classic, you know.
Are you very confident that you're going to be beating both of them?
Yeah, I'm pretty confident right now. I mean, with the official game, it went well, but like, I don't play it that well, I would say. So let's see.
And just that aside as well, who do you see as like your biggest rival in the LEC so far? Like, do you think, I guess maybe especially after today, that Fnatic could be like that big rival for you guys, that team that you have to take down?
I mean, yeah, I think Fnatic, I would say, is playing the best right now. I think they're the best in the league right now. And I think Razork as well is the best one in the LEC. So I would say Fnatic.
Something funny that I've heard from North America, inspired from FlyQuest, recently apparently said in an interview that he thinks that most European junglers are vegan junglers, as he always say. And I mean, obviously, we already said that you play a lot of like Maokai and Zedrani and stuff like that. What do you have to say to these allegations? Do you think this statement is true?
I mean, like, inspired calling vegan jungler is a bit weird because he's like, I feel like he's really FK. Like, he likes a lot to farm. I mean, I would say in you and, for example, me, like Razork. I mean, I don't think it's that true. Like, I don't think you junglers are only vegan. But, like, I think Inspired is really vegan jungler, though.
Well, hopefully we'll get to see you play against Inspired at Worlds. But, yeah, that aside, I mean, I think that's about it for all the questions I've had. But I just have one last question for you, because I think a lot of people have doubted SK Gaming, and I think especially as well, like, Niski has been the target for a lot of like criticism in the past, and I can imagine that you've also probably had some criticism from fans or just people that follow the LEC in general. So I would like to ask as well, like, how do you deal with like outside opinions like this, and especially as a rookie, like, how do you keep yourself confident, and how do you make it so like you know that like you are a good player and you keep like believing in yourself to continue playing well?
I don't really care about criticism, to be honest. Like, it didn't really like impact me. I know what we are capable of. I know, I mean, in both ways. I know, I know I'm very flippy, I would say. Can go in a really good way, but also in a really bad way. So, I mean, I don't really care about the criticism, to be honest. So, yeah.
All right. Do you have anything you want to say to your followers and SK fans in general before we finish?
Yeah, I mean, thanks a lot to like all French fans. I mean, there is also Spanish fans that followed me, that send me message after the game and all that stuff. That's very cool, and that's it.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much for your time. In any case, I wish you the best of luck with SK Gaming for the next
few
weeks.
Thank you.
And hopefully we'll talk to you again, either in the playoffs or even at Worlds, who knows.
Yeah.